Folks, today we're going to be using a sterling silver plated setting that I removed the cabochon from. It was plastic and just falling out, so we're reusing it today. I just put liquid clay to hold the main part of the pendant down, and I'm mixing up some of the backing right now. I'm going to make sure that's nice and flush, fill in any low spots. Now we're going to start with our first anemone. If you're on the Facebook page, you watched me doing this live. Here we're going to start forming the stems and hollowing out the middle. And we're just building up that piece of anemone coral right there. Now we're going to be making some cup coral. And I apologize for my dirty fingers. You can see from working with the black clay that it stained me up just a little bit. Hazards of the job, I suppose. And working on our second anemone. We're just building that up from the back. And making our way to the front. And now we're just building up the front. I'm starting on a brain coral here, and this one was actually super fun. I've never done one like this, but it was a lot easier than I expected it to be. Now I'm just going to go through and separate the cavities that got squished while I was pushing this down. Here I'm going through and making little marks in the coral to better represent it as it is. This will also give it that more distinguished brain look. This part was very tedious, and my eyes did start to hurt after a little while. I probably should have used the magnifier helmet that I have. But of course I'm stubborn, and I didn't. But we got through. Alright, on to the next piece. I'm really not sure what this type of coral is called, but I thought it was really pretty. I saw a photo of one and I decided to try to replicate it. Basically, just roll it out into a flat sheet and then start creating some holes. I believe it's a type of fan coral. And we're going to pop that in the bottom corner over here. And I decided to throw some seaweed into this piece as well, just to really give it that underwater feel. And now we're going to be making some more cup corals. Here I am mixing a reddish clay with a yellow clay to give it an orange tone. And we're making some more corals here. These are exactly the same as the first ones that we started with. The only difference is that they're just the baby version. And I'm just kind of sticking them around to fill in any blank spots up along the brain coral. I decided that the purple piece was a little bit too big, so here I am cutting it down and I'm peeling away any little extra bits, and then I'm going to move this over just a little because I do like it in the corner. I just feel like it stuck out too much. And I'm just fixing the holes that got smooshed during the moving process. And giving it a little bit of a wave. Here we're doing another cup coral. And a second one. Again, this is just to fill in any gaps. We're doing some more seaweed here. And now I'm rolling out some blue to create a yellow and blue sea urchin. During our live feed, one of my friends and I had made a joke about it looking like flounder because I chose blue and yellow. But that wasn't my intention, it just kind of turned out that way. Now I'm just adding the lines for it. And then I baked this to specification. For the clay that I was using, it was 275 for 20 minutes. We're all finished now after I put these last little dots in here. I want to thank you guys for sticking with me. I know this video was kind of long, but it needed to be to fit everything in. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Click that subscribe button and turn on the bell icon for any notifications. You can find this piece in my Go Imagine store. That address is goimagine.com/thegreenbead. And don't forget to put that E at the end of green. See you guys next time. Thanks!